Today's video on our MRI Online review series to learn MSK MRI Radiology is the first in a series on how to find a rotator cuff tear on MRI, and in particular how to find a supraspinatus tear. To start with, we're going to look at the rotator cuff anatomy on MRI, and in particular what's called the leading edge of supraspinatus. The leading edge of supraspinatus are the anterior-most fibers of supraspinatus, and this is a region where a tear can get missed if you don't look specifically at that leading edge. So where is the leading edge? The best way to find it is to start off with the sagittal scans and to find the biceps tendon. So here's the long head of biceps tendon. This is the posterior margin of the bicipital groove. And the anterior-most fibers of supraspinatus insert right at the margin of the posterior aspect of the bicipital groove. So here's the bicipital groove. This is the supraspinatus tendon, and these are the anterior-most fibers. Now, if we cross-reference that, we are on this slice, we're anterior to the bicipital groove. We're now coming into the bicipital groove. We don't see biceps all that well. This is it here. It's a bit partial volumed. And if we go one back, we are now at that posterior margin. The slice is going through the anterior most fibers of supraspinatus, and here they are. So this is these are the anterior most fibers of supraspinatus. And when we go back one more, now we see that appearance of supraspinatus inserting at the footprint, which is the most common appearance. But really where you need to start looking for supraspinatus tears is not here where you see the footprint, but more anteriorly where you have biceps tendon, and just right at that next slice posterior, that's where the leading edge of supraspinatus is. These are where tears can get missed.